My name is Ambarish Rawat. I am a third year BSc student in physics. So here I am going to show you about a very interesting thing which is called soap films and soap bubbles, and also deals with a very important law of universe which is called the law of minimization. We are also going to discuss about an universal law, which means that for a given task, if there are n possible ways to achieve that, then universe always chooses one which is having the least amount of energy expended into it, or you can say the least effort is used. So in a way, energy is like money for the universe, and it wants to be economic with that. Okay, so it all must have come to you as a wonder that why soap bubbles are always spherical. You haven't seen any cubical bubble floating around. So the reason being that because surface constitutes a surface energy, and the universe is trying to minimize that, and it comes that for the same amount of volume, if you have cube enclosing it, you have pyramid enclosing it, you have cylinder enclosing it, sphere comes out to be the one shape which is having the least surface area. So here we have different shapes. We have a tetrahedron, we have a cube, and we have a prism. Alright. So the problem now is we have to find a shape which will be enclosed by these boundaries, and still it will have the least surface area possible. So let's dip it in the soap solution. Soap films form precisely that shape which is enclosed by these boundaries and still have the least surface area. You can notice that all angles here are equal, they are 120 degrees, and I will be explaining it. Let's try this for prism. See, all these angles that are formed, they have that precise geometrical interpretation. And a study of surfaces naturally confirmed that, in fact, these surfaces can always be predicted with these particular angles. For example, if you can imagine that there are three cities at these three corners, and you want to build a road network which connects all cities and still have the least length possible, that comes out to be that configuration which is inclined to each other at 120 degrees that you saw in the soap films. So, let's just say, he was so confident of this method, and he said, given a particular configuration, if you want to find out a shape which is enclosed by that and you still have the minimum surface area, you just dip that in soap solution. And he predicted two important laws about the nature of shape. First, whenever three surfaces are meeting to each other, they will always do that at 120 degrees. And if there are four surfaces, it is done by 109.47 degrees. Now let's try for this. You can see this, it's a bit of hourglass structure. Again, this 120 degrees configuration. And here there are four surfaces you can see, and the angle is 109.47 degrees. Alright? This is amazing part. As this is a cube, our common sense tells us that it can be wrapped up with a cube, get a minimum surface, but no. Nature predicts it. See a small square formed at the center. See a small square formed at the center. From the sides, it doesn't look like a square. what exactly is happening is that the surface tension fluid is trying to minimize the area for the reason I told at the beginning, because the universe is trying to minimize the energy or minimize its efforts. So it automatically is forming that shape which will be having the least surface energy configuration or the least surface area. So if I try for this helical structure, I get a surface which is very popularly called as a helical. Or you can even get a movie span. So all these beautiful structures are formed by these soap rooms who are just trying to follow a universal law of minimization.